Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And this here is the Brother Hobby Hyperbola 5-inch ultralight FPV drone, or quadcopter if you prefer. Yeah, so when you've seen the title of this video, today I'm gonna maiden fly this very nice looking quadcopter. Yeah, and let's hope it still looks nice after the flight today. Yeah, so as per usual, I always main fly the quadcopter's line of sight. Well, almost always. And I'm on a different location here. I hope that you'll be able to see the quadcopter better here, because I'm on an elevated... This is a dike. If you're familiar with the Netherlands, this is a dike. Actually, a waterfront. Or a water barrier. Over there's some water, and if that water would rise up from rain, then this dike, yeah, it's called a dike, should prevent that from, going further inland. There, that's a bit of Dutch trivia for you. Okay, so, but I was hoping that you'd be able to see the quadcopter better because I'm higher up and... Yeah, we'll see how that works out. Okay, so I'll be flying the quadcopter with the brand new Jumper T18 Pro. The quadcopter only comes by the fly, so I have mine with an XM Plus, Eversky XM Plus receiver. And I'll be flying it on this LiPo, an 850 milliamp hour 4S Tattoo R-Line. Now this one has an XT30, as you can tell, so I've made me a... conversion cable. I hope you'll be able to see that. Yeah, I do have some of these exact LiPos with slightly thicker wires, probably, and an XC60 on the way. But for now, for a line of sight, this combination should work out. Let's see if it does. Here we go. Alrighty, there we go. Arm. We are indeed armed, and we are up and away. Now, one of the things with every quadcopter is, for me at least, how easy is it to actually fly line of sight? Is it easy to maintain orientation? And needless to say that it does in fact fly. And I'm flying it bone stock. And that means stock ratings as it came out of the box. Stock tune, and you will probably, well, partly because of that tractor over there, you won't be able to hear the quadcopter at all. Yeah, thank you very much with your tractor. But even if there wouldn't be a tractor, can you hear? Yeah, you can hear the quadcopter a little, but it is very much a silent quadcopter. In fact, when I did a first arming of the quadcopter without the propellers on the bench, I could not hear these motors at all. Also, if you want to know the specs of this quadcopter, they are in the description of this video. And as always, there will be a couple of links in the description of this video to this quad. One to Brother Hobby's own webshop, and one to Banggood. And there you'll see prices, but also the specs and some product pictures. Nevertheless, even if you were able to hear the quadcopter as I can, it is a whisperer, this. Yeah, far more than any other quadcopter I've had before. Now that's probably due to it being light. Also, you have probably noticed how well it flies by now. Stock tune, right? Stock tune, and no oscillations whatsoever. Super duper quiet, this quadcopter. Let's try a punch out. Oh, hot cheeky day. I should add that it hovers at approximately 25% throttle. Yeah. So I don't think it's really necessary. but maybe a throttle curve would help you out, especially if you fly a lot of different quadcopters. And that's true for me, of course. Still, I have no trouble maintaining the altitude that I want. The yaw rate is definitely lower than I'd like, so I'll increase that, especially for line of sight flying. This quadcopter is very peppy. Yeah, acceleration is great, which is to be expected, of course, with a feather weight. Okay, maintaining orientation, yeah. That's challenging. I wouldn't call this a great line of sight quadcopter. Maybe actually the 7-inch version of this one would be. I'd definitely be interested in trying that. It is obviously meant to be flown FPV, right? Damn! Yeah, acceleration, gorgeous. I hope you'll be able to hear me. I think you will. There is a little bit of wind. But yeah, should be all right. Obviously, at this location, out in the open and on top of this dike, I'm more in the wind, if you will. Yeah, this is a peppy quadcopter. I cannot wait to fly this quadcopter FPV. For now, however, I am very happy that it flies this well. So far, I can't see or hear any reason to do any pit tuning, and we'll see if that's actually true in the FPV flights. But it sounds buttery smooth. Again, these pancake motors, and that's one of its selling points, I think. These Brother Hobby motors feel and sound super duper smooth. Very, very nice. Yeah, obviously, I am happy it performs this well so far. And let me see here, the quadcopter doesn't seem to have any trouble slugging along this 850 milliamp hour battery along. And it can probably be flown on a 650, but so far I can't see a reason. Maybe in a race? Maybe in a race, yeah, you could definitely get a 3-minute flight in on a 650, I think. And you'd be cornering better. Cool stuff. You tell me in the comment section below what you think of this location for line of sight flights. Again, I am out in the open a little more. Usually I do these kinds of flights at the soccer club, where I'm shielded from the wind more than I am here. But yeah, you should be able to see the quadcopter better here. Is that actually true? You tell me in the comment section below if this is a better location for line of sight test flights. Cool! That's it for now. Thank you very much for tuning in, of course. In my next video on this quadcopter, there will not be a tractor. And we'll be flying it FPV in my next video on this Brother Hobby Hyperbola 5. Very nice so far. And again, there will be two links in the description of this video. And I am not getting a kickback from Brother Hobby itself, from their site. If you were to use the link at Banggood, you'd be helping me out for future review samples of review items, review products. Thank you very much in advance, of course. For now, I want to thank you for watching. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye. that was ugly. Hot damn.
8 minutes.
8 minutes? You know what? If you're still here, I've done 8 minutes and line of sight flying is never pedal to the metal, of course, but 8 minutes, I will throw up my end voltage on screen for you right now. So 8 minutes on an 850 4S and let's land it. And again, thank you very much for tuning in. Bye bye. And again, if you're still here, this LiPo is stone cold. So this you could probably get away with a lower C rating and have the quadcopter be lighter. Again, this Tattoo R-Line is stone cold. Okay, and the motors are maybe 3 degrees over ambient. Cool stuff. Okay, bye bye.